Good evening, dear women.
Good evening.
I would like to bless all of us. This is Rosh Chodesh Elul. We are already in Rosh Chodesh Elul. So let's bless all of us, Bezrat Hashem, and Klal Yisrael all over the world, and especially in the land of Israel. שיגיע המשיח צדקנו במהרה בימינו אמן שיגיע המבשר אליהו הנביא אליהו תשבי אליהו הגלעדי במהרה יבוא אלינו משיח בן דוד אליהו הנביא זכור לטוב Dear women, I would like to speak about the month of Elul, but I would like to remind you this coming Wednesday בסייעתא דשמיא we have a big gathering of women in Queens and from all over in the Bukharian Community Center, Bezrat Hashem. And I would like to see all of you at 8 o'clock at night. We are going to be two rabbitsons giving lectures over there. We're going to have Sudat HaMenim B'Siyat HaDishmeh. It's a big Kiddush Shamayim, and all this is for the children of Israel, in the land of Israel, and all over. And we need all of the prayers that we can get, Bezrat Hashem. Amen. I just gave you now, with the women, dear ladies, that spread it out, papers of thank you. You had in English, in Russian, and in Hebrew. A thank you letter to Hashem. Please, from tonight, say and read every day until B'Siyata Dishmaya. We are 120. And we pass from this world with every day the letter of thank you to Hashem. Each and every one of you. We need to do the great, we need to show Hashem gratefulness. Another thing, this is Rosh Chodesh tonight and tomorrow, which it is, dear women, the 30th of the month of Av, and then this is Tuesday, and Wednesday is the first day of the month of Elul. We gave you, dear women, We gave you this. Esgula for good chatima, chatima, ktiba v'chatima tova is to read the whole book of Tehillim. Oh, bruchah ba, bruchah ba. Gamit zirka chak kaze. Wait, I'll give you two. She needs in English. One.
Okay, I have
two. Here, one, two, three, and I'm giving her. What you have, you can read for yourself.
Come see.
If I had you speak, I don't know. לא. אבל אין לי. כן. One, two, three. So, self for receiving Mashiach. Again, we are preparing ourselves for receiving Mashiach. The whole world is prepared. You can see what's going on in the world. So the whole world is prepared for Messiah. Kol ha'olam. Everybody sees that we are already at the end. And in a minute, all the fire will go up. In Europe, there's already fire. Europe, dear women, the fire is under the ground of the people that are walking. They just do not understand this. But in a minute, everything can go up. So, dear women, we are already at the end. Now, this is the right thing to say. Hikon likrat Elokecha Yisrael. So, prepare yourself, dear women, for the Shechina, for the divine presence of Hashem and Mashiach. We are mamash at these times. I would like to tell you that it's a big segula to read the whole book of Tehillim from the first day of the month of Elul until after Yom Kippur. Please write. Everybody has a pen. So it's not from tomorrow. It's from tomorrow is Tuesday. It's the 30th of the month of Av. So you read it from Wednesday. Wednesday morning, during the day, dear women. And it's divided. Every day, only three chapters of Tehillim. Mm-hmm. So the first day of the month of Elul, if you look at the table, the first day of the month of Elul, you read chapter 1 to chapter 3. The second day, chapter 4 to chapter 6. The third day, chapter 7 to chapter 9, dear women. Every day, only three chapters, and it starts from Wednesday. Do you understand? Look at the table, if you don't know. Everybody, look please at the table. And you'll see that at the end of the month of Elul, we finished until chapter 87. Then we have Rosh Hashanah. Again, each day of Rosh Hashanah, only three chapters, including the 10 days of atonement, Aseret Yemei Teshuvah. After that, we have Yom HaKippurim. On Yom HaKippurim, dear women, we have Kodem, before we start Kol Nidrei, before we go to the synagogue to say Kol Nidrei, in order to take off of us promises and oaths,
after we start the fast, we have to...
Before we say Kol Nidrei. Okay? Before we say its chapters, we have, dear women, 115 to 123, and then, dear women, before we go to bed, we have chapters 1 on Yom Kippur, 124 to 132. After Musaf, in the morning, after we finish Musaf, remember, Musaf is only after Shacharit. So after we finish Musaf, we say 133 to 141. And then it's written, yes, the Ketuv Po. And then, dear women, after Ne'ilah, we say 142 to 150, and we finish the whole book of Tehillim from the first day of the month of Elul until the end of Yom HaKippurim. It's very important to do this. This is a segula for kod ktiva v'chatima, to be written in the book of life and to be sealed in the book of life. Because the Psalms of King David, Tehillim, dear women, include everything. Everything that we want. Everything that we do. Kaparot, chatanu, avinu, pashanu. Everything is included in the Tehillim. And especially for the sin of spreading seed in vain, the mamash only to read the Tehillim. It's a big mitzvah to read Tehillim from the first day of Elul until the end of Yom HaKippurim. So you have everything. If you don't have, I will give you. Do you have, Hannah? If you don't have, I will give you. Okay, so let's continue. Shh. It's good to spread it out. Listen, I know that some read the whole book of Tehillim. So, dear women, tidu lachem. A person who does on Shabbat, please concentrate, you understand? Okay, a person who does on Shabbat, does Ta'anit Dibur, what do I mean Ta'anit Dibur? Starts to read the whole book of Tehillim, and then reads the Parsha, the portion of the week, and reads things, and does not speak to anybody during that time. Tidu lachem, the whole Shabbat, it's like he did, dear women, 65,000 at least taniyot. Fast 65,000 on Shabbat. At least 65,000. If you don't speak, you don't say anything, you just read the Tehillim, listen to a Torah lesson, and what you only need to say, the blessing for the bracha and things like this, during Shabbat, it's like more than 65,000 fasts in one Shabbat. Okay. So if you can read the whole Tehillim, you remember Nira last lesson, we divided the Tehillim. So this Shabbat, we all read the Tehillim, at least 40 Tehillim together. Yishar Koach, we're going to add people for this.
Every Saturday.
Yes, we're going to add people for this. Yishar Koach, this school of mitzvot. I would like to tell you, I would like you please to read the thank you to Hashem, to be grateful to Hashem every day until a long life we pass away. We gave it out in Hebrew, English, and in Russian. Another thing. We put inside www.rabbanitiris.com, we put inside the site of Women's Torah Education, we put, dear women, all the division of all the chapters of Tehillim for all occasions. And what kind of Tehillim to read every portion of the week. There's specific Tehillim parallel to the portion of the week. And how to, and also all the high holidays. We put inside the site all of the chapters of Tehillim for each holiday that we can eat. You can go and go under Tehillim. You will see, you go into the home page and over there you see Tehillim, you press on it. Another thing, we put all of this B'siyata Dishmaya, all the tables are inside the site in Hebrew and in English. So you can go into the site under Tehillim and you'll see Sgula Lektiva V'Chatima in Hebrew and in English. Just press on it and you'll see the table. So please refer everybody to the table over there and they can know exactly what day and what chapters to read. If we forgot one of the days, so at the next day when we remember, we add the thing that we forget and we continue, okay, to read the Tehillim. Okay, dear women, Akol Yasham. Everything is in the site, rabbanitiris.com, with a double B. So this is about this, B'Shah Tova. Let's continue.
It is the Shushan and it's one table.
Do you have one table?
Yes, I have another table. Wait. Okay, girls, let's continue. Tomorrow morning, and then the Ivrit Banglit. But then Ot Katan. In the tabila, in the zeta gadol.
Very katan.
Very katan. Okay, girls, let's continue. Tsimi ze leadech po. Shekol mi shetzarich shifne. If you need something, call Bella. And this.
Bader.
No. I'll take.
Oh, it's fun, Yika.
I wanted to tell you that we lit candles for Rosh Chodesh in the merit of the word Shema. We lit now candles because we need help, big help from Hashem. And this is for Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. Shimon Bar Yochai. And this is the Shin. And the Mem is for Rabbi Meir Baal Hanes. And then, dear women, Rabbi Akiva. So we lit now candles. May Hashem in their merit bring Mashiach. Amen. We need Mashiach not now, but a day before. Yesterday we already need Mashiach, and you can see what's happening. Together it's the word Shema, Shema Yisrael. So dear women, that's what we did. We lit three candles. Please, when you go home, light candles to the word Shema for Rosh Chodesh and ask, and put money in charity box, and ask from Hashem that He will save all of us. And the Siyata Dishma, that may will have the merit to go back to the land of Israel. Amen. With mercy. Amen. And not with judgment. Three candles, okay? One for Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, the other one for Rabbi Meir Baal Hanes, and then Rabbi Akiva. The initials together is the word Shema, Shema Yisrael. We need Hashem to listen to us. Ayom balayla, mechar babokam, matay shetem rotzim. Okay, we have 2 days of Rosh Chodesh. And we have twice a chance to visualize the name of Hashem and concentrate on the name of Hashem of the month of Elul. Remember that every Rosh Chodesh, before Rosh Chodesh, I tell you, the Arizal says, why do the children of Israel daven and the prayers are not answered? Because they do not concentrate on the name of Hashem that is for that month, Yud Kei Vav Kei, the name of mercy of Hashem. So this month, the month of Elul, it comes from the verse, Utzdakah Tiyeh Lanu Ki. And charity will be for us because. It's part of a sentence. And the name of Hashem is Utzdakah, the last letters in each word, Tiyeh Lanu Ki. So I'm writing it over here. You need only to concentrate on the name of Hashem. And I'll remind you where. So it's Kuf. I'm writing Kuf because I can't write the Hey. And then another Kuf. And then a Vav. And a Yud. This is the first name. And the second name, the name of Tshuva, the name of repentance, is Kuf, Kuf, Yud, Ve'Aleph. Okay? So those two names, you write yourself in Musaf of Rosh Chodesh. Musaf of Rosh Chodesh is in the morning. After we say Shacharit, tomorrow morning we say Shacharit. Dear women, we say Tfilat Shmona Esre. Then we read from the Torah. And after we read from the Torah, there's Musaf. After we say Shmona Esre, Halel, Torah, and Musaf. In the Musaf, we come. The Musaf is the standing prayer of Tfilat Shmona Esre. So over there in the middle, we come to the place when we say Baruch Ata Hashem, Mekadesh Yisrael, Berashe Chodashim. So over there we say Baruch Ata Hashem Mekadesh Yisrael. We stop and concentrate. We do not take the letters out of our mouth. So you can write it in the Siddur. We concentrate on the letters of Hashem, Yud Kei Vav Kei, for this month, for Elul. So we concentrate on, I write Kupa, you know, this is the letter Hey, because then I cannot wipe the board if I write the name of Hashem. So we concentrate on the letter Hey, and another letter Hey, and the letter Vav, and the letter Yud. And then the second name, again, Kuf, Kuf, Yud, Aleph. Just see it and visualize it in front of your eyes. That's what we need to do. And this opens a gate of prosperity to Klal Yisrael and the whole world, of peace, of phosphor, of parnasatova, of marriage, of having children, everything you need. We need just to concentrate on the name of Hashem. So again, on Musaf of Rosh Chodesh, at the middle, when we come to Baruch Ata Hashem, Mekadesh Yisrael, Verachshe Chadashim.
I'm sorry. Could you please just say a few words about second name? What does it stay for? First name we know. Second name.
The second is the name of Tshuva. Ehyeh Asher Ehyeh. Hashem, Moshe Rabbeinu asked Hashem, you remember Parashat Shmot, Chumash Shmot. Moshe Rabbeinu asked Hashem, Hashem, you are sending me to your children, the Israelites. Please tell me, what is your name? What shall I tell them? And Hashem told him, Ehyeh Asher Ehyeh. This is the name of Tshuva, repentance of Hashem. And I will explain it, but not in this shul. It has a lot of secrets around it. So these are the two names that we concentrate. This is the name of Hashem for this month. Okay. Now, dear women, we're going to go through the minhagim of the month of Elul. Can I wipe it or should you need it yet? Okay, I'll leave it. We are going to the minhagim of the month of Elul. So first of all, dear women, it's part of a verse that says, and charity will be for us because... So the last, this is from the Arizal, the last letters of each word, you see it's combined to the name of Hashem. This is the combination for the month of Elul. The month of Elul is the last month of the Jewish year. And we'll speak about it, Bezrat Hashem, if we'll have time, we'll speak about it. First of all, the minhagim, the customs of the month of Elul. We start to say slichot. And the time of Slichot, dear women, Sephardic people say Slichot from Rosh Chodesh Elul, dear women. So we start on the month of Elul. Why? Because it says that the month of Elul until Yom HaKippurim, this is a time of will. Why is it a time of will? Because after the children of Israel sinned with a golden calf, Im Chet HaEgel, what happened is Moshe Rabbeinu went down from the mountain of Sinai and he broke the tablets. He broke the tablets. Then Hashem wanted to punish all of our enemies. And Be'ezrat Hashem, what happened? Moshe Rabbeinu went back to the mountain and Hashem gave him the second tablets. Moshe Rabbeinu made the tablets and Hashem gave him the second tablets to give to the children of Israel. He went up to the mountain of Sinai on the month of Elul. At the beginning of the month of Elul, he came down with the tablets on Yom HaKippurim and Hashem told him, Salachti kidvarecha, I forgave the children of Israel exactly as you asked me. That's why these, how many days do we have? We have 30 days of the month of Elul. Look over here. We have 30 days Elul. This is the month of Elul. We have 30 days. And then we have from Rosh Hashanah to Yom HaKippurim, Rosh Hashanah to Yom HaKippurim, we have 10 days. Together it's 40 days. Mikveh Yisrael Hashem. Mikveh Yisrael Hashem. The mikveh of the children of Israel is Hashem. Dear women, there was a rabbi that didn't have time to go before Yom Kippur to the mikveh. You know what he did? He went among all of the people that stood over there to pray and stood over there like this and he says, now I was in the mikveh. Uh-huh. Because mikveh Yisrael, the mikveh of the children of Israel is Hashem. The children of Israel, when we are gathered together, it's like a mikveh. The whole children of Israel. And why? What is 40? Shh. What is 40? 40 is the amount, for Abayim Seah is the amount of water in the mikveh. It's 40, it has to be 40. This, why? Because it's 40 days of repentance. The 30 days of Elul and the 10 days of atonement, together it's 40. 40 is the 40 days that Moshe Rabbeinu went up to the mountain of Sinai to receive the Torah. The first 40 days is for the first tablets, and then another 40 days for the second tablet, dear women. So we see this is 40. Zed, dear women, mikveh. You see the word mikveh? Mikveh is Kuma. It's the letters of Kuma. Kuma Hashem. When do we say Kuma Hashem? When we take, before we take the Torah out, we say Kuma Hashem v'yafutzo aybecha v'yanusu mesanecha v'panecha. We say to Hashem that all of his enemies, because we don't have really enemies. The children of Israel don't have really enemies. The nations that hate us, or people who hate us, they do not hate us. They are the enemies of Hashem because we are his firstborn. We are the daughters of a king and the sons of a king. We are the firstborn of Hashem. We are princesses and princes. Mamash kacha. So anybody that hates the children of Israel hates, all of his hatred goes to Hashem. Hashem knows because Hashem says, these are my children. If you dislike my children, it means that you don't, even though they say that they pray to their God, but it's not true. Because if you know what the essence of Hashem is all about, it's about life and repentance. And it's about loving each other. It's about the truth. So dear women, anybody that hates the children of Israel has a problem with God. In our equation, in the equation of the children of Israel, there's God inside, there's Hashem inside. So anybody who has a problem with us, he has a problem with Hashem. But in order that in heaven every we have protection, we have to be awakened here. If we are awakened here in this world, there's also awakeness in the true world. Because what we see now, all the prosecution of the children of Israel, all over the media, and all over Europe, and all over the countries, it's because there's prosecution also in heaven. So in order to stop this, first we have to say thank you to Hashem. We are grateful for all of his deeds in this world, everything that he gave us. Then we have to repent. We have to accept upon ourselves something. We have to do that, each and every one of us, because we are responsible for each other. This is the time to do this. This is our obligations for each other, dear women. We have to repent to Hashem. So we start slichot in this synagogue, in the Georgian shul, it's on Thursday at 6 o'clock. Slichot you can say after midnight, dear women, until the sun rises. So over here in the synagogue, it's Thursday morning at 6 o'clock, dear women.
I'm sorry, are women obligated to? Because I heard
no.
Women are not obligated.
No, women are not obligated, but today...
Yeah.
We need to help the men.
So you
can even say that at home. You can say that at home, but then you don't say the 13 attributes of Hashem.
Yeah.
When a person is praying at home, and we are allowed to pray at home, mm-hmm. you just do not mention the 13 attributes of Hashem. Only when you're... Only when you have minyan of 10 men, and they can mention. But if you're at home, dear women, we can say everything, except for this. We can say the whole prayer without the 13 attributes of Hashem.
I read it just for the sake of learning with translation. Am I allowed to?
That's something else. If you, for the sake of learning, this is something else. But only for the sake of learning. Otherwise, a person alone cannot say the 13 attributes. He has to have Eda. Eda community is called, is the minyan. It's 10 men that have to be there. Okay? So we have Slichot. The Sephardic started on the month of Elul, and Ashkenazim, they start the Slichot after Parashat Atem Nitzavim. Atem Nitzavim Hayom Kulchem Lifnei Hashem Elokechem. You are all standing in front of Hashem, your God. And this is the time exactly before Rosh Hashanah, because Rosh Hashanah is the big judgment day. The whole world is judged. Every human being in the world is judged. us, we are just first, and then all of the nations, dear women, each and every person is a judge on Rosh Hashanah. So usually, Parashat Nitzavim, the portion of Nitzavim, is before, always, the portion of Nitzavim is the Shabbat before Rosh Hashanah. But if Rosh Hashanah falls on Monday or Tuesday, then they start, the Ashkenazi start to say Slichot a week before, because at least 3 days of Slichot they need to say. So by Shulchan Aruch they start, then a week before. This we don't have the problem this year, because anyway it's a Thursday, Friday and Shabbat. So dear women, we'll come to it Bezrat Hashem before Rosh Hashanah. We'll speak about all the halachot and everything of Rosh Hashanah. On the month of Elul, we take for checking, it's a minhag, and it's very good, tichle shana veklaloteha, tachel shana veberkoteha, to check our mezizot and the tefillin of the men. Take it for checking, the mezuzot of the house, call a rabbi to see it, the tefillin that the men put, remind them to check it. It's good to check it at the end of the year in order that we'll start the year with no problems. Okay? Because sometimes there are letters that, or part of the letters are wiped out, and it's very dangerous, and it's so you have to lakpid in this to check the mezuzot and the tefillin. We spoke about slichot, and I told you that we, the Sfaradi, started on the month of Elul, and then the Ashkenazi, after the Shabbat before Rosh Hashanah, dear women, and then we go to chapter 27 in Tehillim. Dear women, we read chapter 27 in Tehillim at the end of Shacharit and at the end of Mincha every day, which means every day twice we read it. Every day we read chapter 27 in Tehillim from Rosh Chodesh Elul until, dear women, Shmini Atzeret, after Sukkot, twice a day. So if we don't pray, as women, we have only obligation to pray one prayer a day. So we read twice the chapter of 27 in Tehillim every day. Add to your Tehillim chapter 27 every day. Except this is also, it's addition to the Tehillim that I told you, three chapters every day. I'm just reminding you, every day from Rosh Chodesh, from the first day of the month of Elul, which now it's on Wednesday, we read three chapters of Tehillim, and we add every day three more chapters until the finishing of Yom Kippurim. So this is the way we read the whole book of Tehillim, spread out over the 40 days of atonement, the 40 days of will. That's why it's so important. Not you can read the whole Tehillim the same day, but still separated. Three chapters every, and who can, anybody that can read Tehillim also standing? It's a big merit to read the Tehillim standing. So I'll give you an example. So I try on Shabbat Bli Neder to stand and to read the whole Tehillim standing. It's very, if you can. Only on Shabbat, Bli Neder, right? And if you can, it's good to stand and read the Tehillim. Especially, כי בעמידה לפני הקדוש ברוך הוא. קומה, בדיוק ככה, כמו מקווה. קומה. So, and why? You know what, מה זה קומה? You know, קומה, which means awake, stand, לקום. Look at this, and this is the letters of מקווה. So if I look at this, קוף מם, זה קם, you see? קם, awakened. And then look, dear women, it's the name of Hashem. The letter Vav and the letter Hey. You remember, kiyad al kesiya milchama l'Hashem ba'amalek midor dor. Until Amalek is vanished from this world and eliminated from this world, the name of Hashem is only Yud Kei. And this is the completion of the name of Hashem. So when we stand and read the Tehillim, it's a big merit, we complete the name of Hashem. If we can, if you can. So if you can, like once a week, read the Tehillim standing at least. It's a big merit to read the whole Tehillim standing in front of the Western Wall, in front of the Kotel in Yerushalayim. A big merit. Everything that you wish comes true. To stand in front of the Kotel and read the Tehillim without stopping. Tani Dibur. to be in a fast of speech, not to say any word, not to answer anybody, just to read the book of Tehillim. It's a big merit, dear women. So now I told you to reach, and why do we read chapter 27? The whole 40 days, and also it's 30 plus 20, 51 days, because it's 30 days of the month of Elul, and then we have 21 days until after Sukkot. It's 51 days. You know what 51 is? 50 is Nun, 1 is Aleph, it's Na. Ana Hashem Oshiana, Ana Hashem Atzlichana, Ana Hashem. And it has a lot of secrets, the word Na. So it's 51 days. It has a lot of secrets. So we read the whole, and why? Because chapter 27 in Tehillim includes all of the high holidays. Shh, listen, I will show you. It says that David, it's not David. Who is David? It's Mashiach ben David. It's the Messiah. Mashiach ben David. Le David, Hashem ori v'ishi. Hashem ori is my light. He will bring me light on Rosh Hashanah, because everything that we eat, we bless that it will be sweet, and all the judgment will be taken off of us, and only mercy and kindness will be upon us. So this is for Rosh Hashanah. It's the light of Hashem. Rosh Hashanah. And then Be'ishi, Hashem will save me on Yom Kippur. He will write me in the book of life. This is Ishi. And then it comes, Kitzpeneni Besukkot. Hashem is going to protect me in His Sukkah. So it's also Sukkot. So all of the high holidays are in chapter 27 in Tehillim. Another thing, dear women. Chapter 27, write it down, has 30 times the name of Hashem, Yud Kei Vav Kei. In chapter 27, Chaf Zayin, in the book of Tehillim, it 13 times the name of Hashem, Yud Kei Vav Kei. The name of mercy of Hashem. So we read it twice, we have the whole name of Hashem. Because 13 multiplied by 2, it's 26. It's the name of Hashem of mercy. 30 times the name in the... Yeah, I'll explain again. 13 times the name of Hashem in chapter 27 in Tehillim, Yud Kei Vav Kei, the name Hashem, appears in this Tehillim. We read 13 plus 13 because we read it twice a day. So twice we are mentioning the 13 names of Hashem inside, it's 26. 26 is the numerical value of the name of Hashem, Yud Kei Vav Kei, of mercy. So we cause the mercy to be upon us. On the 13th day of the month of Elul, write it down. On the 13th day of the month of Elul, it's also the yahrzeit of the Ben Ish Chai, Rabbi Yosef Chaim, dear women, Zchuto Tegen Aleinu. On the last lesson we studied from his book, on the 13th day, go to chapter 13 in Tehillim,
chapter 13.
13, and read it 13 times. Again, on the 13th day of the month of Elul, on the 13th, Yud Gimel Be Elul. Can I wipe over here?
Can't Shani Bemet.
Look, I'll write it over here. On the 13th, Shemu Lachem Yud Gimel Elul. Yud Gimel Elul. It's the 13th of the month of Elul.
13 days, 13 times what?
Read the chapter. Read Tehillim. Chapter Yud Gimel, chapter 13. 13 times. It's a big segula. It's parallel to the 13 attributes of Hashem. You remember? Yeah, the 13 attributes of Hashem. Hashem, Hashem, Mikel Kamocha. We have Hashem, Hashem, Kel Rachum Bechanun, the 13 attributes that Moshe Rabbeinu received. And we have Mikel Kamocha, Noseh Avon Vover Al Pesha. You remember, this is the 13 attributes of Micha Navi, Micha the prophet, that received from Hashem. So dear women, chapter 13 in Tehillim, on the 13th day of Elul, read it 13 times during the day. Everything is during the day. During the day, and then ask for Mashiach and everything that you wish for. It's a big segula. And it's also the yahrzeit of the Ben Ish Chai. It's the yahrzeit of the Ben Ish Chai, which is Rabbi Yosef Chaim. Okay? Zchuto tagen alenu. We are studying the 13 attributes from Talmud Dvora, Rabbi Moshe Cordovero. So now, dear women, that we understand that we read twice a day, during the day, dear women, chapter 27, and you understand the importance. This way you feel in the name of Hashem, Yud Kei Vav Kei, of mercy. Now you'll see every morning in the month of Elul, at the end of Shacharit, there's a man that blows the shofar. We blow the shofar. This is a minhag, dear women. At the last day of the month of Elul, we do not blow because we want to distinguish between minhag and the commandment to blow the shofar. So every day, if you come to the synagogue after Shacharit, we hear the shofar. It says, "Im itaka shofar ba'ir ve'am lo ichrad." If a shofar is blown, some of them are translating to people that don't understand. So if, dear women, if the shofar is going to be blown, people will not be afraid. The meaning of shofar is to wake up people in order to repent, to do tshuva, dear women. In order to repent and do tshuva, that's why we blow the shofar. I would like to show you something. I will wipe over here so I can write things.
Oh, Baruch Haba.
Baruch Hashem, תראו. Kadosh Baruch Hu אוסף אותם, Baruch Hashem.
יש מקום שם?
Okay, let's continue, but not. How do we repent? What are the tools that we need? Shh. I told you, shh. Bli neder b'siyata dishmaya. We need tzniut. As women, if we are tzniut, dear women, if we are tzniut, if we are modest, shh. We went through this. Tzniut, tzaddik is 90. In numerical value, Nun is 50, Yud is 10, Ayin is 70, Taf is 400. How much is it together? 490, 500, plus
70,
570,
plus
50,
620. Is the word Keter, crown. Dear women, as women, we are not commanded to do all the mitzvot like men because Hashem commanded us to be tzniut. Hatzna lechet im Hashem Elokecha. Hashem said, women, be tzniut. When Hashem created Chava and He took the rib from Adam, every part that He filled in her, Hashem said, be modest, be modest, be modest. We need to be modest. When we are modest, we are keter. We have a crown on our heads.
Right.
Go.
We have a crown on our head. What does it mean? Keter, I already said that in one of the lessons. 620, we have 630 mitzvot deoraita. We have 613 commandments from the Torah. And then we have seven commandments, the Rabbanan, from our sages. 613 plus 7 is 620. Exactly like Keter. So a woman that is modest, like it's like she fulfilled all of the mitzvot in the Torah. Just by being modest. That's why we don't have the commandment of doing all of the mitzvot in the Torah, because by being modest, we already fulfilled all the mitzvot. But if God forbid, im Hashem ishmo, we did not fulfill the commandments, this keter becomes karet.
Oh my God.
I want you to know, this keter becomes karet.
what's correct?
It's death. Death of the nefesh. The rostam. You see, it's the same letters. You see, chav, reish, betav, lo aleinu. It's the same letters of Keter. Dear women, take it to your heart. So each and every one of us, and the viewers also, will take one mitzvah of modesty, at least one to start, so that the shirt will be closed up till here, the sleeves up till here. Covering the head is a queen. It's a must. Thank you. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu, melech haolam, shakol niya bidbor.
Amen.
Amen.
The covering of the head, you always sit next to me. The covering of a head is a big mitzvah. Bli neder, over here. Elsa, from now on, Bli neder, she sits next to me.
No.
So the, I'll prepare her down next to the tree. Okay, so girls, by being modest, we fulfill all of the mitzvot in the Torah. This, you remember, we spoke about it. And lo aleinu, if we do not do that, it's karet. And the first thing that women is asked in heaven, why are you modest? Because this is how we were created, to be modest. That's why Hashem took the rib from a place that is modest, that is covered. He didn't took from any part of the body apart from the man. He took from the rib because the rib is covered. So we need to be modest. And please, take upon yourselves, Bli Neder, for 4 weeks, on Shabbat, to cover your head. Totally cover your head. It's better to cover with a tichel, with mitpachat. Listen very carefully, by the Zohar Kadosh. I know there's mentioning of a wig. לא, אבל איך קוראים עוד פעם וויג?
שייטל.
שייטל. דרוך, זה ברח לי מהפה. There's a mentioning of a שייטל also in the Gemara. But you're allowed to wear שייטל for your husband at home. That's the difference, not when you go out. So there was גזרות. איך הוא מגזרות? Decrees, yes. I'll explain to you. In Europe there were decrees and then the rabbis let the women put shaitels. But I want you to know the right way, dear women, is to put a tichel, to put a mitpachat al arosh, dear women. This is by Shulchan Aruch. Shulchan Aruch is for all women, all Jewish women. Ashkenazi, Sephardic, and Yemenite. All of them are included in Shulchan Aruch. Because Rabbi Yosef Karo, when he wrote Shulchan Aruch, that combines all of the Jewish laws, he also went to Europe to see if anybody wrote Shulchan Aruch before him. Look how modest he was. Before he took it out and gave it to the children of Israel. And Rabbi Moshe Iserlich Harama, he also started writing Mapa LeShulchan Aruch, a cover to Shulchan Aruch. Then what he did, he saw that Hashem gave the merit to Rabbi Yosef Karo to give the children of Israel Shulchan Aruch. And Rav Avadia Yosef was the reincarnation of Rabbi Yosef Karo to bring us back to Shulchan Aruch. So over there's a Hagaot, mentioning of all the Ashkenazi minhagim inside Shulchan Aruch, which means everything that is written is accepted by all of the children of Israel. Ashkenazim, Sephardic, and Yemenite, all of them in Shulchan Aruch. So I would like to tell you, please, at least on Shabbat, cover your heads, each woman and all the viewers, take upon yourself a mitzvah for 4 weeks. A mitzvah. If you don't do the netilat yadayim in the morning, take a mitzvah upon yourself. For 4 weeks, I will do netilat yadayim. After 4 weeks, it will become part of you. You will continue with this. So, dear women, it's very important because this is tshuva. Lo alecha melacha ligmor. Hashem says, I do not expect from all of you to finish doing the whole tshuva. But I need to see that you sincerely want to come one step to me and another step. Because it's like digging a tunnel. And now there's a lot of tunnels from the Gaza to yes, it's. So how do we dig a tunnel? Hashem says, you're going to dig from your side And I'm going to dig from my side, and we will meet together. I will help you. But you have to show an effort, a sincere effort, that I truly want to do tshuva. So at least the shirts should be closed. And over here, and the elbow, up to here, it's not a big difference between here and here. It's only the even inclination that tells us that if you go with this shirt or this shirt, it's not hot, it's not warm. But if you'll put it, the sleeve up till here, it will be, it's not true, it's only the evil inclination. You'll see once he wants to cover your head, he wants to cover your hair, dear women. Once you want to cover, people will come to you and say, wow, you look so beautiful without this, why do you put this? So this is the evil inclination. Dear women, we are on the month of Elul. Please take upon themselves, because I'm telling you, it's niyut. It's like we fulfilled all of the mitzvot. Everything, it's a crown over our head. Queens, mamash, the daughters of a king, dear women.
Did you say that it's a kares because of that? Did you say that?
Keter, if you change, you see, the letters is karet.
Okay.
So he who doesn't fulfill the mitzvot of the Torah, dear women, he who does not fulfill the mitzvot of the Torah and does not do shtniut, Hashem, yes, it's karet. You see over here? Correct. It's the same letters. We cannot hide from Hashem. We cannot tell him that we are more comfortable now. Hashem, alasot, you know, most of the society walks like this. We cannot say that because of society, we also behaved like this. Hashem says, now you're standing alone. In the womb of your mother, you studied the whole Torah. You came to this world to know me and to fulfill my commandments, Hashem says. And what did you do? Because before the soul comes over here, it goes through paradise and through hell. You already saw what happens to a person who does not fulfill the Torah. And Hashem says, dear woman, I didn't ask you to fulfill all the 620 commandments. I gave you only 3 commandments. Challah, the taking a portion of the challah, the purity of the family to go to the mikveh and counting 7 days, and dear women, hadlakat nerot, and to light the candles, and 1 prayer a day. 4 mitzvot, and being modest. That's what I asked you. Not more than this. This is the mitzvah that I asked you. So Hashem will ask us, did you fulfill the mitzvah? Were you modest? What will we tell him? How can we stand in front of Hashem and say, no, Hashem, we didn't listen to you? What will he tell? What will he tell Hashem? You remember the brothers of Yosef. When they stood in front of him, Yosef says, I am Yosef, and they all passed away. Their soul went out of the body from the fear that they had because of the things that they knew they did to him. So the soul, neshama, knows what we are doing to Hashem. But the body doesn't want us to pay attention. And the body says, no, don't pay attention. You are in society, you have chevra, you have to be part of them. When they repent, you repent. We do not have time anymore. The world is on fire. And when everything will start, there won't be any repentance anymore. Nobody can repent because of the fear that there will be in the world. Listen, and what Hashem gives me to give you now is life. This is mamash chaim. There won't be time to repent. There will come a time that there won't be time anymore to repent. That's what's written in the holy books, in the prophets. So now is the time to repent. Let's go out of this lesson, us and the viewers and Klal Israel, and accept upon us something. Accept upon us something, especially in tzniut. Everything that we know that we do not fulfill, we'll accept upon ourselves. Even if it's hard for us to cover the hair on Shabbat. Only Shabbat, 4 Shabbatot. Let's cover the hair 4 Shabbatot. If it's very hard for us, it's for we are only visitors in this world, dear women. Once we come to this world as babies, we start counting the days that we have less in this world. That's it. It's only a big test, and the evil inclination works very hard. I can tell you, very hard now, and it works on everybody through our thoughts, through our feelings, emotions. It works so hard that it metashtesh ta'emet, like it makes clouds over the truth, that we cannot see the truth, truly the truth. We have to mamash have siyata dishmaya, to see the truth out of the falseness. Mamash siyata dishmaya. So what do we do now? So from the month of Elul, we do עוד תשובה, עוד צדקה, עוד תשובה, עוד צדקה, עוד תפילה, עוד צדקה, מעבירים את רוע הגזרה. If we repent and we pray to Hashem and we give charity, this takes off all of the bad decrees, not only from us, but for all Klal Yisrael and the whole world, dear women. How do we know that? This is part of verses that are in the Torah, that in the initials of the verses we have the month of Elul. Look, demal Hashem Elokecha et levavcha ve'et levav zarecha. It's from Chumash Dvarim, and it says that Hashem will cleanse your heart and the heart of your children. So if you look, your heart starts with Aleph and with the Lamed. Your with an aleph, levavcha, your heart is with a lamed. Then we have vav and the heart of your children. What is this? Elul. This is Elul. You see? So we need to repent. And then we have tefillah. Ani ledodi vedodi li. I am to my to Hashem and Hashem is to me. I will repent to Hashem and Hashem will help me with this repentance. And we see it starts ani I with aleph. And then Lamed Ledodi, and then Vav, and then Lamed, together it's the month in Elul, you see? The letters of the month of Elul. And how many days do we repent now? We have 40 days, because we have Ani ends with a Yud, Ledodi ends with a Yud, Vedodi ends with a Yud, and Li again with a Yud. Together, dear women, we have Yud is 10, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 10, 4 multiplied by 10 is 40. 40 days of atonement, the month of Elul and the 10 days of atonement. So we can see it over here. And then we are going to Megillat Esther, it says, Umishloach manot ish lereu matanot levyanim. And we bring tzedakah with food to people, to each other, and matan and money to poor people so they can do the holidays, the high holidays. And if we look very carefully, ish לראהו מת איש לראהו במתנות במתנות לאביונים דיר וומן. So you see אלף למד וב למד אלול.
But this is in month of in Purim.
נכון, this is from Megillat Esther in Purim, but inside there, I told you the whole Torah is a secret. Inside we can see what do we need to do on the month of Elul. Charity, to do tzedakah. Inside, dear women, inside our Torah, when we go, we dive into the ocean, dear women, inside the Torah, there are hints about everything. Everything that happened, everything that is happening, and everything that is going to happen. We just need to cleanse ourselves in order to see it, dear women. So you can see, עוד תשובה, עוד תפילה, עוד צדקה, מעבירים את רוע הגזרה. So these are the tools that we need. Even if we don't have a lot of money, even a dollar, $2, give to charity. It's important to give charity. Even if we don't have money, it's important to give charity, dear women, because this is a true belief in Hashem. Especially when we have a lot of money, because dear women, the money is not ours. Nothing is ours. The money is not ours. It's only a loan from Hashem to us, and we are only His messengers. Hashem says, "Okay, I gave you a lot of money. I would like to see what you do with it. This is your fixing in this world." You know, that's why it's so important to open the hand. Why? Because once we go out of this world, we are not buried with the money. We are not buried with anything, dear women. Everything stays in this world. The person that comes after us, he gets everything. We go up to heaven only with mitzvot, commandments, and good deeds. That's what we go. Mitzvot ve'ma'asim tovim. This is the only thing that we take with us, dear women. You remember I spoke with you last lesson. We spoke about heaven. There's heaven tachton, Gan Eden tachton, and Gan Eden. I write it on the board. Look, it's very important. Already over here.
All of heaven
should be. Look.
I have to open my eyes.
Dear women, you remember we spoke about paradise today. We spoke about this world, Olam Hazeh. We spoke about this world. We spoke about Gan Eden Tachton. And then we spoke about Gan Eden Elyon. There's paradise in this world, and Hashem is going to show us paradise in this world.
Amen.
Bezrat Hashem. Amen. And then, after people pass away, if they have the merit to go to paradise in this world, this is paradise tachton, lower paradise, so Hashem takes their soul over there. Then, from there, when they have the merit, they go up to in heaven paradise. Okay? Shh. What did we say about this? Hashem created the senses parallel to the pleasures that we're going to have in paradise. In this world, we have the mouth. We have pleasures with the mouth, peh. You remember, spoke about it. Then in paradise in this world, there is the chotem, the smell. By smelling, we enjoy, we eat, but the food is not physical food that we eat with our mouth. We eat with our mouth in this world in order to do the fixing of sparks of holiness that are in the food. So this we do with our mouth in this world. In lower paradise, I give everything in the last lesson, but I'm just giving you a small thing. In paradise on this earth, dear women, lower paradise, then the food is by smelling. The soul has enjoyment from the smell of paradise. This is Gan Eden Tachton. Gan Eden Elyon is from the eyes, Enayim. From the eyes. You remember we made the calculation, and together in numerical value, it's 408. And we spoke about it, dear women. But what is 408? I would like to show you. 408, dear women, is Zot, Vezot HaTorah Shesar Moshe Lifnei Bnei Yisrael. Vezot HaTorah, and this is the Torah that Moshe put in front of the children of Israel. Zot, Bazot Yavo Aaron El HaKodesh. With this, Aaron is going to come to the holiest of holiest. Zot, the word Zot. Zayin in numerical value is 7. Aleph is 1. Taf is 400. How much is it? 408. Exactly. With all of the three senses that we receive paradise with. Look. But I want to tell you, chapter 27 in Tehillim says, chapter 27 in Tehillim says like this. I'll write it over here. It has also Zot. It says over there, dear women, Im takum alai milchama, bazot ani boteach. If a war like we have now, dear women, chapter 27 in Tehillim, this is from that we read now twice a day, Tehillim 27, Chaf Zayin. It's written, bazot, you see, bazot. 408. So it says, if I have a war against me, nations are going against me, people are going against me, Lo Aleinu, like we have now, with this, I have the confidence that Hashem is going to protect me. What is with this? Dear women, this is Zot. What did we say? We say it like this. The Utshuvah. Utfila, utzdaka, ma'avirin et ro'a gzarat. Shuva, repentance. Prayer and charity takes off a bad decree. Nachon? This is what we say. Mm-hmm. So, dear women, we have tzom, kol, ve'mamon. Tzom is fasting. Kol is the speech of speaking. Ve'kol, kol Yaakov, our power is in our mouth. The way we pray to Hashem. When we say Baruch Ata, it means that Hashem is in front of us because it's the Nocheach. Ata is Baruch, blessed are you. It's like Hashem is standing in front of us. Baruch Ata Hashem. He's looking at us. He's standing in front of us when we bless. Hashem Elokeinu. We have to understand what kind of a ma'amad. we are standing in front, when we start blessing Hashem, we cannot deal with other things in the world. And every time when a person davens and says a prayer, everything comes to him. The evil inclination knows it. Everything, the phone rings, the children ask you, the husband is calling, everything from all over. Because the evil inclination knows the merit of praying, and that the Shekhinah comes in front of us because we say, Baruch Ata Hashem Elokeinu. We bless you, bless are you, Hashem Elokeinu. So they know that the angels come and the Shekhinah is around us. So, dear women, how do we repent? We fast. So, Tzom, look over here. This is fast. Tzom. How do we daven? Kol, Va'akol, Kol Yaakov. And the voice is the voice of Yaakov. Vetzdakah. How do we do charity? With mamon, with kesef, with the money. So let's look at it. Dear women, tzaddik is 90, vav is 6, and mem is 40. How much is it together? 90 plus 40? 130 plus 6? 136. Kuf is 100, vav is 6, lamed is 30. How much is it? 136. Mem is 40, another mem is 40, vav is 6, Nun is 50. How much is it together? 136. 136 plus 136 plus 136 is 408.
That is so.
Zot. With this is what King David tells us. With this, I know Hashem, you're going to help me win the war, because I come with tshuva, with repentance, with tzom, ta'anit, I do a fast, and I come with tefillah, with a voice, I pray to you, and I come with you with charity. Dear women, it's so important to give charity, v'tzedakah tatzil mimavet, from any bad decree, charity saves. I always say it. In my house, I put a cup, a plastic cup, with a lot of coins, and there are several kupot tzedakah. And every day, my children and everybody that comes to me, before they go out of the house, before they begin the day, I tell them to take their right hand and put money in the charity box, and then they go. So it's so important when they come and kiss a mezuzah, that the name Shomer Daltot Israel Shaddai will be with them, and then they can go out of the house. And when they come again, I ask them, I do this, because usually when they come, I'm in Mincha, I do this, they already know, put charity, everybody knows. When I do this, they know, take your hand and put charity in charity box. Dear women, this is Bezot Sofor. 408, which is parallel to the mouth, the mouth, the nose, and the eyes, and we spoke about it last lesson. And if you look at it, dear women, if we look, this is the eyes, this is the nose, and this is the mouth. Look. So we have Yud, it looks, two eyes is Yud. Yud is 10. And another Yud is 10, and this, the Vav is 6, is 26, the name of mercy. This is how Hashem created us. Yud, Yud, Vav. Look, Vayetzer. Vayetzer Hashem Elokim. This is how He created us. Two Yudim and a Vav. He wanted to protect us with His name, Hashem. So Yud, Yud, two eyes, and the nose, it's 26. And then we have the mouth. Mouth is another Vav. So another 6. How much is it? 32. It's Lamed Bet Netivot Chokhmah. Netivot Chokhmah. It's 32 parts of wisdom. This is what Hashem created us. So if we are modest, we have the merit to be a container of the Torah of Hashem and to light the world with the name of Hashem in it.
Amen.
And if we don't, everything, it's like we have machsumim. We like have
covering
around our face. Hashem created us with His name. That's the face. That's part of the secrets of the face. So, dear women, if you don't remember, go to the last shiur. I think Racheli already discussed the mitzvot, put it in. Amen. Dear women, I would like to tell you, King David says in chapter 27 in Tehillim, Im takum alai milchama, the children of Israel, if there's war against us, we shouldn't be afraid. Be brave. Don't be afraid from anybody, because in our equation, in our mathematical equation is Hashem. Nobody can touch us If we are united, if we remember Hashem, if we repent, we pray and we give charity and we find the merit of each other, each and every one of us, the good things in each other, and we won't prosecute each other, then no nation can touch the children of Israel. Look, Ben Porat Yosef, about all of the miracles that Hashem does to the children of Israel in Israel. This is, it's above nature. Because Hashem loves the children of Israel. Hashem knows that we are with pure heart from Him. And you can see how when this Tzuk Eitan started and the Muslims did what they did, the women, you could see how the children of Israel gathered and helped each other. And it didn't matter if a person is keeping commandments, doesn't keep commandments. Everybody was one soul, one human being. I would like to bless all of you in this Rosh Chodesh and Klal Israel. May Hashem bring Mashiach Tzitem B'Mirabi Ameinu, Amen. May Hashem bring the Mevaser Eliyahu Nabi, Eliyahu Tishbi, Eliyahu Giladi, B'Mirai Avanim, Meshach B'David Eliyahu Nabi Zechur Latov, L'Olam Yiparat Adam Yichavero Midbar, L'Acha Yachid, B'Rabim, L'Acha K'Rabim. I love you. I love all of you girls.